Hey guys, welcome to episode 6 of the strength series. These episodes are all about gaining muscle and cutting fat, specifically for guys. In this episode, I'm going to talk about insulin and the glycemic index. There's a lot to cover, so let's get started. When you eat carbohydrate, the food will get broken down into glucose molecules and they enter your bloodstream. So if you have a donut, that will get broken down into glucose. If you have a starchy carbohydrate like pasta or rice, that will still eventually get broken down as glucose, but the process takes longer. Once the glucose is in your bloodstream, that raises your blood sugar levels, and that will trigger the release of insulin from your pancreas. When insulin is released, that is going to halt all fat burning because it wants to deal with the food that you've just digested. Your muscles and your fat cells respond to insulin by getting ready to absorb the nutrients from the meal you've just eaten. By releasing insulin, your body is trying to return your blood glucose to a normal level. How much insulin your body releases depends on many factors, but we're going to focus on two. One, how much your blood sugar spiked from the meal that you ate, and two, how sensitive you are to insulin. So we'll start with one, blood sugar, and that brings us to the glycemic index. The glycemic index is the relative ability of a carb-containing food to increase your blood glucose levels measured from a fasted state, and that depends on how fast you digest the food. It's based on a scale between 0 to 100, with 100 being pure sugar. You might have heard of it in its abbreviated form as GI. Low GI foods score 55 or less, and that is things like sweet potato, oatmeal, brown rice, and most vegetables. High GI foods score 70 or above. That is your donuts, your chocolate, your sweets, as well as some slightly more surprising foods like cornflakes and sweet tasting foods like honey. Another consideration is glycemic load. That takes into account whether the food is high or low GI, but also how many grams of carbs the food contains. So you could have a large serving of a low GI food like oatmeal, and it could still spike your blood sugar levels. Alternatively, a very small serving of a high GI food like honey might not have as big an effect. Diabetics can use the glycemic load to assess how suitable a meal is at maintaining stable blood glucose levels. Since blood glucose ties into your energy levels, the best thing for you is a slow and steady release throughout the day. The one exception to this is after a workout, where you want to replenish your body's glycogen. Now, your muscles store carbohydrate in the form of glycogen, and that fuels your workouts as well as your daily activities. In terms of how much you can store, a very rough rule of thumb is 10 grams for every kilo of lean body mass. So for me, I can store about 600 grams of glycogen in my muscles. There is also a small amount in my liver. If I run or lift weights, my glycogen stores are going to get depleted. How depleted they get depends on the intensity and duration of my workout. If you've heard of marathon runners hitting the wall, that is when their glycogen stores run very low and your body turns to fat as its primary fuel source. Your body can't burn fat as efficiently as carbs, so your running suddenly feels a lot tougher. On top of that, your brain also runs on glucose, so if your brain and your body are competing over a tiny share, then you're going to feel pretty crap. So I lift my weights, my glycogen is depleted, and I want to replenish it after my workout. Here's a good time to put in those high GI foods. So I'm going to take on 30 to 80 grams of a fast digesting carbohydrate along with a protein shake. That's going to trigger an insulin release and it's going to shuttle all those nutrients straight to my tired muscles. You don't need a massive increase in insulin, so don't feel that it's necessarily the more carbs you eat, the better. If I'm trying to gain muscle, then I also want to create an insulin spike first thing in the morning. My glycogen stores have dropped overnight and I need to top them up for the day. Here I'm going to take on about half what I took on after my workout, and fresh fruit is a popular choice because of the way it's digested. So to recap, I want to eat foods that keep my glucose levels steady through the day, except for after a workout, and if I want to gain muscle, then breakfast too. My second factor I mentioned earlier was insulin sensitivity. That is the amount of insulin your body releases to deal with the spike in blood sugar. The more frequently you ask it to deal with these spikes, the less efficient that your receptors become at taking glucose and other nutrients out of your bloodstream. So to get your blood glucose levels to come down, your pancreas is going to release more and more insulin. That cycle is going to continue if you insist on spiking your blood sugar levels, and that eventually leads to type 2 diabetes. If it sounds like your diet is creating these spikes throughout the day, then you are slowly becoming insulin resistant. The more resistant you are, the more likely that any carbs you do eat are going to get stored as fat. All that extra glucose in your bloodstream is also going to get deposited as body fat and as cholesterol. As well as that, because your receptors aren't absorbing properly, you might not be getting all the nutrients from the food you eat. In the next episode, I will talk about how to increase your insulin sensitivity, which should be your goal whether you're trying to gain muscle or lose fat. Thank you for watching.